Soon, soon, everyone. Welcome back to Emnix Plays Path of Exile, Legacy League. Let's stat. Is there a better way to get a bigger game screen but still see chat? You can actually pop out the chat. So if you have two screens, you can do that. Otherwise, you can pop out the chat and make the video screen a bit bigger, and then have the chat somewhere smaller on the side, something like that.
Probably use chat on your phone or something like that.
That's possible too.
An option.
So today it's not 8 o'clock yet, so I can't do any dailies. Suppose I'll do some more maps. So last episode we managed to get, we're on tier 3 maps now. So slowly, I'm actually going, pretty fast considering how, how we went last time around on our previous character. Area contains two unique bosses. Players have 20% less recovery of life and energy shield. That's probably okay. I really, really would like my zombies or to get to 1,000 life. I'm still pretty far away. I'm at 640. 640 means I still need, 350? So 35 strength nodes? Obviously, I'm not going to get 35 strength nodes. Gonna have to see. Probably the jewel sockets is gonna be the way to go. Where does Soonsoon come from? Soonsoon came from when I was playing in hardcore last league, or maybe 2 leagues ago actually. When people finish a trade, they always say TYSS. Oh, one of my flame sentinels died. Holy shit. When did this happen? People say TYSS, and it's supposed to mean thank you, stay safe after a trade. But I was not aware of this, and I kind of just assumed they said TY soon, like The Sims. I don't know why I thought that, but for the longest time, a lot of these guys play The Sims, it seems. But obviously that was not the case. And from then on, I'm like, I can't be the only one that thinks that. So whenever I finish a trade, I say TY soon. And that sort of became my thing, I guess. And, I'm wondering if I say it enough, maybe people will start actually believing that it means soon instead of say safe. Yo, man, tilting the world. Just turn it upside down. Frostbearers gotta watch out for that. I mean, that's probably how our Spectre died.
Damn bears.
The bears. I learned my lesson. I remember I died like 2 or 3 times to the bears. The bearers. I'm like, never again. Now I'm just like crazy scared of them. And it's a common thing that kills even experienced players. Like, you're not paying attention, fucking clear speed meta, and bears absolutely wrecked them in the butthole.
You're doing off-screen clearing, and you like just teleport in the middle up to a big pack of where the bears are about to explode.
Oh. Was it Curtis who gave you the idea of using it into your intro? I forget who it was. I think it was a viewer. Somebody commented in one of my videos and said, you know what, you should just make Soonsoon your intro. And that's how it came to be. I don't remember exactly who told me though. It could have been one of you, to be honest. I don't remember. Another level. So that's another jewel socket. Is there any int in this jewel socket? Oh! Excuse me. Oh. I'm wondering if I can put Valiant Dead here. Is it attached to 40 int? I think it is.
If it's in the top
One, two,
say
three.
third of the map, it should be fine.
Yeah, I think I got it. With at least it's at it's on top of Devotion in the Templar side, on that left side near that
Okay,
elemental
you'll be
cluster.
good. You'll be good.
I think there's 40 in there, and that way I can put a strength gem over here and convert all the strength or all the int over here to strength. I think that'll be good. Guys, thank you for all the blessings. You guys are a cool bunch. The E blessings. Okay, so I probably have to buy a jewel. Probably sometime. Maybe after this map, I'll pick up a jewel. Just so that I can add a little bit more strength. I forgot what the jewel name is, but I'll figure it out. And since we have some new people in here, you know, we can kind of talk about how trading works. It's possible that you guys don't know, I'm not sure. But it's pretty important to know, so. I want rotten zombies too, mine look kind of weak. One thing you gotta keep in mind in this game is a lot of times you basically have like one or two skills and you're just trying to, you know, make do with them. And you rarely, you know, are in a situation where you're juggling, you know, four or five different attack skills. So just make sure you know, figure out which skill you want to do early on and then stick with it. I don't know if you have multiple characters or what, Naoto, but it kind of sounds like you're using a lot of different skills. You got zombies, you got EK. Just make sure you focus on something. That stat says I never trade. I mean, that's fine. You know, that's what Solo Selfound is for, and you know, even if you're not playing Solo Selfound, I find a lot of times I don't trade either unless, you know, I'm looking for a specific unique where I want a specific build.
In this game, if you try to be good at a lot of things, you end up going to be nothing. You won't be very good at anything.
Yeah, you pick one thing, even drugs. Even
Even
drugs.
drugs. You're gonna pick drugs, but be good at drugs.
Efficient training. Yes, that is the jewel I was thinking of. I was about to go look it up in the wiki, but now that I know, I can probably go pick it up after this map.
You have like a hive mind going on. It's amazing. Right?
Yo,
There's
this is
your exobrain.
like chat is actually fucking amazing.
Good job, cat.
Good job, chat.
Rock.
Do you have any tip on a YouTube channel? What do you mean by on a YouTube channel? Like starting a YouTube channel? Is that what you mean, Team Magic? Only thing I miss is that selling unique to a vendor is very unsatisfying. Yeah, I kind of just keep them, you know? Like, I have all these uniques. I'm like, maybe I'll use it one day, but I know I won't. So they just stay in this little display case of mine.
There is a prophecy, though, that's kind of not bad, right? You can
Yeah, save uniques for a
vendor.
5-for-1 prophecy. That's true. Team Magic, what the Demi said is absolutely correct. Like, I started this YouTube channel not because of YouTube, not because of getting views, but because I like playing Path of Exile. And, you know, with the hope that somebody would watch it and enjoy the game as I do. I don't think you have to go into I don't think you can go into it just for the sake of views. I know it's demoralizing when you make a bunch of videos and nobody watches them, but the most important thing about being a YouTuber, and it's not, you know, sub to sub, you know, oh, sub to me and I'll sub back. all that crap is very tempting, but all it does is it, you know, improves your EPing, but it does nothing for your channel. There are lots of videos where people give advice, but I'd say, you know, the most important tips are just maintain a good schedule, love what you're doing. So whatever your game you're playing, just make sure you're able to play it for, you know, God knows how long, half a year, or whatever. Like, if you are somebody who consistently plays games, or, you know, consistently makes videos, if you're not, you know, a gamer, maybe you're a vlogger, or whatever, you just gotta be consistent. And then the biggest thing is, you know, if you're scared of starting, just do it, you know? The way to get ahead is to get started, really. So that's... Holy shit! Degen damage! That's really, and the Demi's right. You just gotta love what you do, you know. You gotta love the game you're playing, and you gotta be consistent. You know, I can't stress that enough. You know, make a schedule and stick to it. It gets demoralizing at times. You know, you're not getting views, and I get that. But for me, the way I started this channel is I play a lot of Path of Exile, and even if I weren't recording, I would be playing anyway, so I might as well record. That was basically my mentality going into it. And it's sort of that's the mentality I stuck with for a very long time, which is basically, I'm going to play because I enjoy the game, and if someone watches it, then, you know, hooray, right? So that's basically my tip, you know, don't get demoralized and just keep at it.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, just from talking to you, even whenever you weren't getting any views, still doing it.
Yeah,
the consistency. It takes a long time. Just like skip over.
Yeah,
the long time. Nobody's ever super successful.
There's no shortcut unless you're a cute girl. That's a shortcut. Are you a cute girl, Team Magic? If you're a cute girl, like, there you go. Hey, you got a sister? Hey, views right there. I'm only being facetious, but only slightly. Well, that's what I do, but no one watches. I mean, you gotta get lucky too. That's the thing as well. I think with me, at the time when I was, like, you look online, there's not that many people doing Path of Exile Let's Plays. I just kind of found my niche. But, you know, for the longest time, I would say somewhere close to, like, a year maybe, I was getting maybe, like, 5 views a day or something like that. You know, like, for maybe a whole year, every video gets maybe 10 views at the end of the month. Or something like that. Like, I wasn't getting much at all, but I'm like, you know, I'm just playing a game, and eventually people start watching, you know. And then you know, if you have a good personality, you know, at the end of the day, it's entertainment, right? Like, yeah, you gotta get yourself some of that radio voice. Even if you don't, you know, it's just you know. Make sure there's no dead air in the videos. Like, if you want to get down to, like, very specific things, you know, talk more, be proactive. But, like, you know, a lot of people have, like, sub chat. They're like, they work all really hard, and you have to work hard, but they work hard on things that don't matter too much for beginners. Like, they spend all this time on, you know, a sub banner, and then on donation buttons, and they're like, oh, what if people want to, you know, give me money? And honestly, early on, it really doesn't matter. Like, I don't have a Patreon, I don't have any donation stuff, like, I don't care about it. It's just, you make your video, and then make sure you're entertaining, and that's what you gotta do. Well, shit, let me get my sister to do some vids, just maybe. Being a girl on Twitch helps a lot. Yep. Zazarian. Well, I wouldn't say Zazarian. Okay, so Zazarian, like, his case is just, he's, you know, like, consistent. Ziz plays probably, like, he's a professional, right? Not many people can do what he does, and... You know, I respect that, but that's a lot of dedication. my niche is, you know, I'm a casual scrub who plays Path of Exile. Maybe not all the time, but it's often as possible. You know what? You don't have to be funny. You're just your personality just has to be show. Just has to show, right? You know, if you joke around with your friends, you know, like what kind of stuff do you talk about? If you have interesting conversations, like all that stuff, it does add up. So you kind of have to find, you know, what are you good at? You know, are you the joker in your team? Are you the serious guy in your team? If that's the case, maybe you have a channel where you have serious conversations, right? He plays an unhealthy amount of PoE, in my honest opinion. I don't refute that. But at the same time, don't you want to be him too? Well, maybe you don't want to be him, but you want his RNG. And then you realize it's not RNG, it's just the ungodly amount he plays. Therefore, eventually, you know, he hits, like, sample size. Like, law of big numbers is helping him. That's what happens with Ziz. Alright, map complete. Torino! I play by myself, I'm the Joker. Well, if you're the Joker, you know, if you... When I first started recording, it was hard to talk while playing. And I was playing like Crypto the Necrodancer, so that's like a music game with, or not, like it's a rhythm game, and it was like super hard to talk. I was like, I was talking like this because I had to, you know, play according to the beat. After a while, you really do get used to it, and it just, like I said, you just gotta keep going. It just comes down to that.
Keep talking and nobody explodes.
Keep talking and nobody explodes, it's true. What the fuck were they? And I mean, it does take a while, right? And there's a little bit of like, you get camera shy. Like that part is true as well. I removed my fucking, what? Why did I remove these? Some people don't like funny people. There are many channels that are dead serious and people watch it. Yeah, I mean, whatever your personality is, eventually, you know, you're going to get your demographic. You just got to make sure, like, if I come to your channel and I see that you haven't made a video in the last 4 months, even if you have an interesting video, it's hard to, you know, come back. You got to be that guy who, you know, you either make a video every week, you make a highlight video, you got to find your little niche, right? No, it's different if you're a streamer. If you're the streamer, you get a schedule, you stick to it, and then eventually people will like you. And then you got to be, you know, gotta pick the right game, but you know, that's something completely different. I have time for another map. I don't have any more tier 3 maps left, unfortunately. Glad you made it back. Oh, but Xana Daily's gonna refresh in a minute, so I'm just gonna sit here and wait for it. Just gonna wait. It'll happen. 8 o'clock, it refreshes, right? Stay inquisitive. You. How much does the upgraded stash cost? The premium one? Where is it? Account features. $4 per stash tab? If you get it in a bundle, it's... I mean, I would get the premium. Or, what was it? Wasn't there a bundle where you can get a divination, essence, and currency all in one go or something? And a premium?
I think so.
Premium tab bundles, 200. Quicksilver. What's the unique Quicksilver? Rotgut?
Rotgut!
This is actually the time to do the trade. Totally forgot. Hold on. Since I have some time right now. What was the gem called?
Who remembers?
Who remembers?
Who remembers?
Efficient training. I think it was efficient training. So for those of you who don't know, and have never played before, This is a website called poe.trade, and if you've never done trading before, this is basically where you go. You can search up items. You have different item types, and you can say with the buyout and whatnot. I don't know if you've if you're brand new, you probably just haven't heard of this website. This is basically where people go to trade because there's no auction house in the game. So for example, this guy's selling it. They're all selling it for a chaos. So I guess, what if I scale in strength?
What about a roll? Yeah, definitely. Don't just buy the first one.
Okay,
Get
this guy
yourself.
has it for 2 chaos. For 24, that's pretty good. And then you copy this to clipboard, and then you go in game and you press paste. And this guy lets you, and you'll whisper the guy, and hopefully he'll sell you his stuff. If not,
Nice.
he's. And you just
Hopefully,
wait.
they don't ignore you.
You just wait and hope you don't get ignored. This is like high school, and you're like asking people to prom.
Normally, you don't pay people to go to prom. Hopefully not.
You say that. Look, when you ask somebody to prom, chances are you're gonna buy their prom ticket, okay?
What? What?
What?
I
No?
suppose you could. That might
It
be
happens.
the gentlemanly thing to do, possibly.
Clearly, that's not what you did.
I'm a firm believer in equality.
Right, well, this guy's not replying, so let's try another guy.
So you're making sure that you're getting what does it scale to?
It's 24 to strength, maximum, and then intelligence from passives radius is transformed to strength.
No, but I mean how high does a 24 potentially go up to?
24 strength. It's not
Is
percent.
it always 24?
It's flat. It's not
I
brawn.
know, but if there's no range, that's what I meant.
It's like 12.
Probably goes up to
18 to 24.
18 to 24. Okay, so you're getting the 24.
I'm trying to. Did this guy reply yet? No, he's not replying. Okay. Do I want to spend 5 chaos? That seems like a little bit too much. I'm okay with 4 chaos, maybe. His stash tab is called Jew. That's racist, by the way. When should I take on the Labyrinth for the Ascendancy class? Sold. Oh shit. I normally like to do it on the end of the next act. So if I'm trying to do the normal ascendancy, I wait until I finish Act One Cruel, and then I would do the normal ascendancy. It's typically my, go-to. Okay, how about this guy? 5 chaos. It's getting more expensive. Oh, this guy's okay with me. Oh, his name's Catch Me Outside. Memer. A true memer.
Ooh, sweet.
Thank you. Soon. All right. This is good. It's good shit right here. If you've got a smooth build, then it's good to go to do it when you get to the end of Act 3. Yeah, if you have a good build, obviously, if you can, doing it in Act 3 is fine. Does this give me more strength? And so this gives me 756. Okay, obviously it's here. What about here? No, this is the spot. That's where all the int is at. How much is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 50 int. That's okay. Is there a better spot? Oh, this is probably the best spot to do the conversion. Okay. So now I'm at 756 in strength. I still have 250 more to go. But maybe if I get, another 60 strength on my rings, that'll bring me up to 800, and hopefully using stats will do it. There are some 23s for 1C. Well, it's too late. It's too late. It's already done. What's the time? Oh, yeah, I wanted to do a Xana daily. Need a map? Stay sane. Okay. Still this is probably the last map for today. It's a plateau map. Slay rogue exiles. What else? Slaying monsters increases time limit. Shocking ground, two rogue exiles. There's lightning resistance here, and they do 54% extra lightning on the map. Doesn't seem too bad. What amulet do I have? I have a strength amulet, just a regular amulet. I don't have Estramentus, so that's one thing that I do need to get, but it's like really expensive right now. It's 1.2 exalts, I believe. I don't have that kind of cash, so I kind of bought something to tide me over. It gives me life, it gives me strength, it gives me, it also raises me up when I'm, I forgot the lyrics. It gives me some ES and all that, you know, good stuff, and resistances as well. So it's basically everything I need, to sort of just, you know, basically I'm probably not switching it until I get Astramentis. Clearing pretty fast. This is actually okay. I don't know if it's the specters, if it's the zombies, or if it's both. But I'm not complaining. How many times have I overleveled cast when damage taken gems? Well, as long as you don't, like, you know, be like me and use a scouring to de-level and then re-level it like an idiot, you'll be fine. I think it's okay if it's been overleveled a couple times. But if you do it too many times, then yeah, it's not good. Especially if you're a character that just can't take hits in general. So any small hit, you want to trigger Immortal Call. Unless it's not, you know, Immortal Call, it's something else. I'm assuming, you know, the typical way to do it is cast one damage, taking Immortal Call.
Yeah, that's one of the more popular ones. Level 1's good. If you're like me, you don't like casting your own golem. So I just have my
golem. Oh, is that what you're doing?
Some damage taken, yeah.
Alright, another rogue exile. Oops. What did I pick up? Here it is. Doesn't Orb of Regret lower the level of a gem by 1? Orb of Regret will reduce the level of the gem to 1. A scouring will lower the level of a gem by 1.
That's really useful. Really useful.
Yeah.
So what instances would you not raise the skill level up?
Would you not raise the skill level up? So, Caswin, are you asking me for me, for yourself,
yeah,
or?
Just general.
Like, probably in most cases for Immortal Call, right?
Yep.
With Immortal Call, you kind of want to. God bless you, Exile. So, Caswin damage taken, the higher level it is, the more damage you need to take before it actually casts the skill. So if cast one damage taken is too high of a level, you won't be able to cast your skill as frequently as you would like. So typically, especially with something like Immortal Call, which gives you damage immunity to physical damage, you want cast one damage taken to be a lower level so that it will trigger more often. But if you have like a spell and you have a lot of HP, you might want a higher level of cast one damage taken, so that, you know, maybe. You can kind of fine-tune it so that, you know, if you get to 20% HP, that's when your cast one damage taken will trigger, and that'll trigger, you know, Molten Shell or a spell or whatever, right? There's a lot of ways to do it, actually.
Yeah. For sure. And if you accidentally level up something and you don't have the strength or the dexterity or intelligence requirements anymore,
that's when you de-level.
Good time.
Well, so they introduced the ability to de-level a gem to one for a couple of reasons. First of all, when the NPCs started selling all gems, they would scale the level of the gem based on your level. So what was happening is that you were getting all these gems that were like super high level and over leveled, and you were like, "Well, I only wanted a level 2 gem for my, Immortal Call or my." Back then, it was Immortal Call and Enduring Cry, right? So they introduced that recipe and kind of kept it. But there was also a use case where a lot of people were using Clarity back in the day, and you didn't want to level it further than level 3 because I think it started going into diminishing returns at that point. So they kept level 3 Clarity at all times as well. So that was another reason to de-level gems. Well,
with enough, okay. At certain points, it just makes sense to start a new one, but
so it's if it's your first character, you're gonna ruin it, probably. Right? Like you either forgot to get enough life nodes, or you kind of picked up everything. You picked up too many stat nodes, or you picked up like stupid regen nodes. Stuff like and like the regen doesn't do anything for you. Like you're like, "Oh, I don't have enough mana all the time." So instead of like getting the Clarity Aura, you just pick up like 10 mana regen nodes. But you never picked up, increased mana nodes. So okay, you have all this regen, but you only have 500 mana, and it's easy to screw it up. Even if you're an experienced player, I think. And then there's like real screwing up,
Too much clutter.
Like you went CI at level 30, or you went ES at level 30, thinking I'm gonna go CI because that's what everyone does. I'm gonna get energy shield. And then you're in Cruel in level 30 and you already went CI and you only have like, I don't know, like 500 energy shield, and you're like, "Why am I dying?" And then you're like, "This game sucks," and well, you have no one to blame but yourself, so. All right, mission complete.
What can I do for you, Exile?
That was a pretty fun map, but it was a little brainless, to be honest, because just talking, so I didn't really think about what was going on. But
hey, Alex.
Alex.
Hey.
Oh, it's actually Alex.
Are you
It's
still
actually
streaming?
Alex.
I am almost done streaming. Probably done in another 5 minutes, I'd say.
Five minutes. Okay, then I will not put it on my television to watch.
Oh yeah, I'm almost done.
That is fine. I'm gonna put on Twitter then. See you. Talk to you guys later.
Later. So I'm just gonna finish up with this Xana daily, pick up all the items. I mean, overall, I think I'm doing pretty well with regards to map progression. We're slowly finishing up with the tier threes.
Too much clutter.
What was the name of the site for trade again? It's called poe.trade.
So if you're new to the game, like how do you find out about that?
You don't.
Crazy.
Right? You go on Reddit, that's how you find out about it. Which is just. That's why I'm like, GGG should make the game more accessible. And by accessible, I don't mean make it easier, just like, offer that resource, put it somewhere on the front page of the game, or just mention it somewhere in a tip so players can actually figure out how to trade instead of going to trade chat where it's just like this clusterfuck of people trying their best to scam you.
Yes, that's another good tip for new players. Don't buy anything at a trade
Oh
shop.
yeah, don't do that.
Don't do it. Just really don't use trade chat. It's the I don't know. Whenever they talk about hives of scum and villainy, right?
Not wrong.
It's like the Mos Eisley spaceport of PoE. It's just no good. There's nobody out there who has your best interests in mind.
Mm-hmm. That's true. So PoE.trade, you know, it's where you find the open market, really.
How are your maps?
And super, I mean, even if you're a person that doesn't like to trade and you don't enjoy it, just being able to get one of those build-defining uniques is pretty important. Like, maybe you don't sell, but at the very least, you probably, like, buy stuff. I imagine you probably do. If not, all more power to you. You're probably playing slow self-found then. And if you're not, why aren't you, you know? Alright. Well, all these maps are sewer maps. Fucking tier 3. Okay. That is the end of this episode. And that's actually the end of the stream as well. Thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching this episode. If you did, as always, you can leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more updates in the future. Otherwise, keep in touch, guys, and I'll see you guys next time. Soon.